Hey there, hello and welcome to Fundo Money. Here we're going to be discussing the issue whether you should be buying a retirement mutual fund. That's right, retirement mutual funds. They are mutual funds which help you save for retirement. They have all kinds of nomenclature: retirement benefit plan, retirement pension plan, pension benefit plan, retirement savings fund, all kinds of variations. All are meant to help you save for retirement. Here we're going to be discussing some of the major features of retirement mutual funds, the things that you should be keeping in mind when you are buying a retirement mutual fund, and then we're going to discuss what are the things you should keep in mind when you're evaluating whether to buy a retirement mutual fund at all or not, because there are other alternatives available for you to invest in savings products which are meant for retirement. The idea is to help you create regular income in retirement. So we are going to be discussing that. The first part is going to be discussing about the features. Second part is going to discuss about the analysis and the desirability of retirement mutual funds vis-a-vis other options. So just in case you're going to find this long, you can go to the description section, hit on the timestamps, look at the chapters, and go to the section that interests you the most. There's an edited highlights there in the description section. So we'll be back shortly, first covering basically the major features in almost all retirement mutual funds, and then we'll jump into analysis, desirability of retirement mutual funds in the second part. So see you then very soon. Welcome back. Welcome to Fundo Money. We are discussing retirement mutual funds, whether you should be buying them or not. Here in this section, we're going to be discussing some of the features, important features that are there across all retirement mutual funds, and we'll be taking them one by one. And in the next section, as we mentioned, we're going to be doing some kind of an analysis, things that you need to check whether retirement mutual funds should be opted for at all or not, and what are the alternatives. And you will find, like us, that as far as retirement mutual funds are concerned, you need to know why you're buying it. It should need to meet your needs, because there are other alternatives which can help you do the same thing. So let's jump into some of the major features of retirement mutual funds. As we mentioned, the retirement mutual funds are meant to help you save for retirement, much like pension plans, products from life insurance companies, public provident fund, national pension scheme. So all of these are retirement savings products, and retirement mutual funds are in the same league, but they're being provided by mutual funds. Now, typically retirement mutual funds have a lock-in of 5 year or retirement, which is whichever is less. Most of them have these features that we are talking about. Some of them have some of them may not have the other, but broadly they have some kind of a lock-in. So you need to keep your eyes open for the lock-in feature. It's not a bad thing, it's a very good thing, because why should you be touching retirement fund at all before retirement? That's the idea, isn't it? You should be just saving more and more. There should be ample money for retirement. So the other thing that happens in retirement mutual funds is this, that you can get to choose from variations. They're fund variants. So you can choose, typically there's a low risk variant where the debt equity, debt, there's more of debt investment than equity investments, because you're low risk appetite. There would be a balance sort of a thing where debt and equity are more or less the same, in the same proportion. And then there would be one which has more equity investments, higher risk, higher reward, right? Potential high risk and potentially higher reward. So that's how they are. Now you can typically, these retirement mutual funds, they allow you to move from one to the other if you're starting out young. So there would be a provision for you to start with higher risk, and as you keep going towards retirement, you move on to lower risk variant. So from an aggressive, or whatever you call it, progressive, you'll move into a balance, then you move to conservative or low risk, whatever. Just the name might vary, but that's how the movement happens. You can do it yourself, the movement from high risk to low risk, and you know, you can also do it automatically. It completely depends on how things are with you. Of course, depending on age, some mutual funds might tell you that, okay, you, since you're young, you can start from a higher risk variation. If you're, you know, if you're like 5-6 years or 10 years away from retirement, maybe a balance sort of fund is what you start with. So depending on how far you are from your retirement, and it pretty much depends on the age, that's how it will be looked at. Now, every retirement product like this, you know, whether it's from mutual funds or life insurance companies, they'll have something called the retirement age. Now, that is very important for you to know, because it should somewhere be near the retirement that you're looking at. Now, if the retirement age is of the retirement fund product, mutual fund product, is 58 and you're thinking of working till 70, it's not really dovetailing nicely. So it still can work for you, but you should have a plan ready when you should be using the money and what you'll be doing. Either if it's not matching up very closely, either you're getting the money early or you're getting the money late. Now remember, all this investment that you're doing in the in your retirement, it's supposed to convert it into a regular income. That's going to happen through a systematic withdrawal plan where a certain amount of money is given to you regularly, and it's done by liquidating units. So a systematic investment plan, as we know, or as some of us would know, is a very it tends to be a more tax efficient way of getting regular income, simply because you get, if it's put in say in a debt fund or debt oriented sort of a thing, which is what you're going to end up being, you'll end up when you're getting near retirement, you are basically moving what you're going to be holding is going to be debt oriented in nature. So what that does is that means you're going to get inflation indexation benefits, and then for the units that you have acquired, and then you're going to be taxed at 20%. Now remember, that's the tax impact is going to be lesser than what you would have paid in case of life insurance annuities, which is taxed at your income tax rate, right? So for a third person on a 30% tax slab, this SWP route starts working better. So this is something that you need to keep in mind. Like all mutual funds, you'll have the growth and dividend option. It's a no-brainer. You need to opt for a growth option. Why? You want the money to grow. You don't want the money to come back. You want the money to be at work. It needs to be at the gym, developing muscles so that it can be a good servant for you when you retire. So you can start with 5,000 bucks or 5,000 rupees. If you're doing a lump sum, it could be, they'll tell you what are the multiples. For systematic investment plan, 500 rupees, and 5,000 is for a lump sum. You can, as I mentioned, you can do auto switch from one to the other. Now, if it's a new sort of an offering, a lot of funds have been launching, then you don't get to do it. You'll have to get a sense of what's new about it. But if you're looking around of something which is already there, then you need to see, like in all other mutual funds, 1 year, 3 year, 5 year performance, and you can go to any good app, a mobile app, investment app, or websites, or you can go to the AMFI site, which is the industry site, and see the performance vis-a-vis the benchmark. You need to see the right benchmark. Ask for the right benchmark. Whoever is selling that mutual fund or proposing to sell it to you, see the benchmark of that fund that you're going to be buying into, and see how it has performed over a period of time. The best performing one is obviously going to tick mark one of the boxes, and some of the other things that we are talking about you should need to be looking at, also some of the things that we'll be talking about subsequently. So these are some of the things that you need to keep in mind. Now there could be small variations here and there, which could be things like that in some mutual funds, the variants that we are talking about, there could be investments in areas like real estate through real estate investment trust, which is REIT, international sort of securities, international debt, or rather international stocks. They could be investing. They could be investing in gold ETFs. So there, the asset classes are much wider. But apart from that, these are roughly some of the things that people would be offering to you, and these are the things you should be asking yourself: do you want to do this, and whether there are other alternatives that are providing this, and why you should be going for it at all. So in the next section, we're going to be talking about whether you should be going for a retirement mutual fund, and what are the things you should be asking yourself before you actually go for a retirement mutual fund. So see you then very soon. Welcome back. Welcome to Fundu Money. We are discussing retirement mutual funds, and here we're going to be discussing whether it makes sense for you to buy retirement mutual funds and what are the things you need to be asking before you get to know whether retirement mutual funds make sense to you. Basically, here we're going to be comparing retirement mutual funds with some of the other alternatives, some essential attributes that you need to keep in mind. Now, remember one thing, that some of the retirement mutual funds, not all, some of them, the older ones, give you tax benefits under Section 80C. Now, if you're looking at tax benefits along with saving for retirement, then there's a few things that you need to keep in mind, because if that is one of the parameters, then a few things suddenly come into the picture. So if you want tax plus very high growth, then retirement mutual funds, if they're eligible for Section 80C benefits, you can get in benefits, annual benefits till 1.5 lakhs. Remember, other alternatives come into the picture, which is equity linked savings scheme. So if you want high growth, equity linked savings scheme, which is again a mutual fund product, it also gets Section 80C benefit, obviously has the potential for high returns. Why? Because it's investing everything, all your money, in equities. Here there's a mix between debt and equity. There could be other asset classes. So because you're managing the risk somewhat or to a great extent, therefore the potential for a high return is that much lesser. So why then there's far more stability here, potentially there's far more stability in a retirement mutual fund, the upside is much more in an equity linked savings scheme. So potentially the return in an equity linked savings scheme is that much higher. Now remember, there's one thing worth pointing out. In Section 80C, you are eligible for other items. Other items are also eligible. You have home loan repayment, you have tuition fees, children's tuition fees, Provident Fund, which is also a retirement investment. It's a low risk investment, retirement investment, which you have to do, which is to be done mandatory. So therefore, to balance that, you obviously need a high risk investment, and therefore, if you're even buying a retirement mutual fund, ideally you should be looking at the highest risk option. Otherwise, you go for ELSS. So that's something that you need to keep in mind. But in terms of potential for high returns, ELSS obviously will have an edge. There's no doubt about it. Now, if you're looking at lower risk, which at a personal level and to us at Fundo Money just doesn't make any sense, then you shouldn't be looking at retirement mutual funds at all, because then there's PPF, is there, Public Provident Fund. Again, you get tax benefits both at contribution. You get tax exemption, not even benefit, it's exemption at contribution, interest and maturity. So, you know, why would you take any risk at all if you were to be that conservative? So in any case, if you have a Provident Fund, it simply doesn't make sense to then again add up out there. You would might as well take a little bit of risk and get the upside. But these are some of the things that you need to evaluate. Now, if you want to really save a large amount of tax, then NPS, National Pension Scheme, is obviously scoring, because you get an additional rupees 50,000 under Section 80CCD1B, and under Section 80CCD1, you get 1.5 lakh. So you basically, for a tier 1 investment in National Pension Scheme or NPS, you are being able to save 2 lakhs. In this case, even if you get the whole 1.5 lakhs, it's 50,000 rupees lesser. So these are some of the things that you need to be looking at when you're looking at retirement mutual fund. Now, some people might think that, okay, because of a 5-year lock-in, there'll be some level of discipline, or, you know, there's some level of buy-in. Now, that lock-in is also then ELSS, that's for 3 years. In PPF, it's like 6 years. So before partial withdrawals are allowed. So if it's a retirement oriented product, even broadly, it'll have some kind of a lock-in. So it is not a standout thing when you compare it with other competing products. So therefore, then you need to have some very good reasons. They can be good reasons, but you need to find out those reasons why you're going for retirement mutual fund. Now, also remember that you know, if you want to have regular income through systematic withdrawal plan, which in this case it does, you can save in an equity fund and get again a regular retirement income from SWP later also. So it's not as if what is being delivered through a retirement mutual fund can be also delivered through some alternatives as well. So you need to in terms of, if you were to look at it, why would somebody actually go for a retirement mutual fund? Somebody who's sort of a passive person, passive investor, wants all of it together. He wants the convenience of saving, doesn't want to take too much of risk, wants some take some risk, and wants that investment to create regular income, then probably retirement mutual fund is something. But if you are one of those up and about types, active types, who can wants to maximize and tinker around in this whole element of first saving money and then creating regular money, regular income, then probably you will be looking at alternatives, right? So what it can do is, apart from some of your regular retirement sort of investment like Provident Fund and some other investments you're doing, this can be your third or fourth investment retirement, so that you know you're creating a retirement portfolio of different investments, and you said, okay, I have got this investment, it will give me this these kind of benefits, and I want a variation happening. And in terms of variation, it may not be such a bad idea, but you can do that. Now, a lot of people can always argue that, you know, in some of these retirement mutual funds, you're getting the option of investing in different asset classes. Now, remember, the same option you can get in multi-asset allocation funds. So multi-asset allocation funds also help you invest in different asset classes. And this automatic movement from one variant to the other, or you doing it, that provision is available. You can choose according to your risk profile. You can have a target date in mind, and according to that date, as you progress towards the date, the progression from one variation to the other, or the fund itself might be doing that variation as it moves towards that date, is all there. So you just have to look at multi asset allocation funds, and you will see, you can just check out whether doing that makes sense or not. Some people might say that, okay, you know, I through a systematic investment plan, one can invest regularly for retirement in a retirement mutual fund. You can do the same in an ELSS, you can do the same in multi-asset allocation fund. So depends on your comfort, depends on what you thinking about it. Some people can also put forward an argument that, because it's the names, there's a lot of people said that there's not much in a name, but sometimes a name helps you anchor your activities. So something, if you're investing in a retirement fund or retirement mutual fund or whatever retirement word is there, it's helping you earmark money for retirement, like a provident fund, you know, you associated with retirement. That's not a bad thing to look at. It's whatever works for you, whatever is effective, that's most important, but that's something that one can look at. So these are some of the things that you should be looking at when you're evaluating whether you want retirement mutual fund or not. Now remember one thing, that when you're investing in retirement mutual fund, as we mentioned, towards the end, you're basically moving towards the tax treatment for that product is that of a debt fund, and it's long-term capital gains that you're looking at. And so whatever tax treatment that happens for long-term capital gains, that's what exactly is going to be happening. So we hope this reasonably elaborate sort of analysis of retirement mutual funds is going to be helpful for you. Clearly, you need to have a good idea. You need to write the ask question. That's what Fund Money tries to do. Help you ask the right question and help you go towards the right answer for yourself, because everybody's needs are distinct and unique. So we hope you found this useful. If you liked it, as always, we will request you to subscribe to our channel, get connected with us on all leading social media networks, and wait for our next presentation. Till the next time, take very good care of yourself, and goodbye.